All. Today we will discuss terminology in CAM. In previous lecture we have discussed the classification of CAMs and followers. Now in today we will look different terms that will be used in designing a CAM. So this is a typical CAM profile. Okay, for example I have taken this shape. There can be a different shape also. So this blue line is a CAM profile, and this dot over here is the center of rotation of CAM. This whole profile is revolving or rotating around this center point, and this circle over here is CAM shaft. So CAM is mounted on this CAM shaft and it is revolving around this center. So let's have a look at the terminologies. First one is base circle. Okay, base circle, it is the smallest circle that can be drawn to the CAM profile. Okay, this is the smallest circle that can be drawn to the CAM profile. Okay, we will use this base circle in developing the this profile while we look in example. So it is the smallest circle that can be drawn to the CAM profile. Okay, its center should be the same as this center of rotation. Don't get confused that smallest circle means don't imagine like this. Its center of this circle center must be same as the center of rotation. Okay, so don't get confused that smallest means one that is having minimum radius. Okay, so its center should be same as center of rotation. So that kind of circle is called base circle. Next terminology is trace point. Okay, trace point, okay, by name you can guess what is the meaning of this trace point. It is the point that we are tracing while the follower is moving around the CAM or CAM is rotating. Now one thing you should keep in mind that in CAM and follower mechanism our CAM is actually rotating and the follower is having reciprocating motion up and down in some fixed guide only. Okay, that is the actual CAM and follower mechanism. But the idea behind this is this follower is actually following the motion of this CAM profile. ये जो CAM का profile है उसके accordingly ये जो follower है वो up and down move होता है. But while in designing the CAM profile we are assuming the thing like this is a CAM. Okay, while designing the CAM we are assuming that CAM is stationary. Okay, CAM is stationary, that we are assuming, and the follower is actually moving around the periphery of the CAM and generating the same motion means up and down motion according to angle. Okay, for example suppose at the angle of 30 degree, while the CAM rotates the angle of 30 degree, then at that time the follower is going up by 10 mm. Suppose in actual practice while the CAM is rotating by 30 degree and the follower is moving by 10 mm, then in our designing problem also this condition should satisfy. Means my center of rotation is over here. Okay, this is my initial position of CAM and follower. Okay, so on this CAM if I measure the angle of 30 degree and at that place at the angle of 30 degree and at that place if I place the follower, then the follower should move in this direction by 10 mm. So suppose this is the reference position of follower, then at the angle of 30 degree this follower is lifted by 10 mm in our design problem also. So in designing the cam we are following this approach. Okay, so that thing you should keep in mind. Okay, now let's get back to the trace point. Okay, trace point is the reference point on the follower. Okay, follower ke upar ka ek reference point hai and is used to generate the pitch curve. It is the point which is used to generate pitch curve. Now what is pitch curve, that we'll look in this today's lecture. In case of knife edge follower, this follower, the knife edge represents the trace point. Okay, this point over here will represent trace point and the pitch curve corresponds to cam profile. So in case of knife edge follower only, this knife edge will act as a trace point. Okay, and pitch curve will be same as the cam profile in case of knife edge follower only. In case of other followers, the pitch curve will be different than cam profile. In case of roller follower, the center of roller, this point, again look, the center of roller represents the trace point. It is the point that we are tracing. Then next is pitch curve. So it is the curve generated by the trace point as the follower moves relative to the cam. So as I discussed that in designing the cam we are following the approach that the follower is actually, we are placing the follower on this periphery of the cam profile. Okay. Our cam is stationary in design approach. So like that, when the follower moves around the periphery of this or around the this cam profile, then these are the locations of trace points. Okay. You can see some blurred portion back. Okay. That is the half portion of roller shown. So these are the trace points of the roller follower as it moves around the cam profile. And if we connect these points, then the profile generated or curve generated is called pitch curve. For a knife edge follower, the pitch curve and the cam profile are the same, whereas for roller followers they are separated by the distance which is equal to radius of the roller. Okay, so in case of roller follower, this distance means distance between the cam profile and pitch curve will be equal to radius of this roller. You can see from figure also. And in case of knife edge follower, if our follower is knife edge type, okay, so at that time our trace point will be the knife edge. Okay, so if I trace the points around the cam profile, then I will get points like these. Okay, I will get point like these. So now if you connect these points, okay, so you can see the curve generated is same as cam profile in case of knife edge follower. So that is what is said in this sentence. Next terminology is pressure angle. Okay, it is the angle between the direction of the follower motion and a normal to the pitch curve. So let's see, this is actually direction of follower motion. One thing you note, that द फॉलोअर मोशन इज सच दैट इट इज पासिंग टू द सेंटर ऑफ रोटेशन. सो दिस इज द डायरेक्शन ऑफ फॉलोअर मोशन. एंड इफ यू ड्रॉ अ परपेंडिकुलर टू पीच कर्व और नॉर्मल टू पीच कर्व देन दी ओके दिस इज नॉर्मल टू द पीच कर्व एट दिस पॉइंट. सो द एंगल बिटवीन दिस टू लाइन्स इज प्रेशर एंगल. This angle is very important in designing a cam profile. If the pressure angle is too large, a reciprocating follower will jump in its bearings. Okay, so if the pressure angle is too large, okay, so at that time our follower will jam in bearings. Okay, so our whole machine will jam. So you should keep this thing in mind. This pressure angle should not be large. Should be as small as possible. Okay. So why this thing will jam in machine? Okay. So if you see the follower motion is in this direction. Okay. My follower wants to move in this direction. But this pitch curve, curvature of pitch curve is such that if we draw the perpendicular to it, it is moving in, it is in this direction, perpendicular to pitch curve. Okay. So this curve, pitch curve, is saying that the follower should move in this direction, which is perpendicular to pitch curve. But in actual actual, our follower is moving in this direction. Okay, so there is contradiction between pitch curve and motion of follower. Okay. So जब भी इसका difference means जो pitch curve चाहता है कि हमारा follower यहाँ पे move होना चाहिए. Okay, ये difference जितना बढ़ता जाएगा उतना ही pressure angle बढ़ता जाएगा. Okay, और follower का motion होगा वो हार्ड हो जाएगा, वो जैम हो जाएगा. ओके, सो दैट इज द सिग्निफिकेंस ऑफ प्रेशर एंगल. इट इज एक्चुअली जनरेटिंग प्रेशर ऑन फॉलोअर, यू कैन से दैट इज व्हाई द नेम इज गिवन प्रेशर एंगल. सो जितना बड़ा प्रेशर एंगल होगा उतना ज्यादा प्रेशर क्रिएट करेगा फॉलोअर के ऊपर, और जितना ज़्यादा प्रेशर फॉलोअर के ऊपर आएगा उतनी ज़्यादा उसकी टेंडेंसी होगी कि वो बैरिंग के अंदर जैम हो जाएगा. ओके, सो दैट इज द इम्पोर्टेंस ऑफ प्रेशर एंगल. नेक्स्ट इज पिच पॉइंट. सो इट इज़ अ पॉइंट ऑन द पिच कर्व. ओके, दिस ग्रीन कलर डॉटेड लाइन इज द पिच कर्व. सो इट इज़ द पॉइंट ऑन अ पिच कर्व हैविंग द मैक्सिमम प्रेशर एंगल. So pressure angle will be present all over the periphery of this camp, this pitch curve. Okay. But pitch point is the point where the pressure angle is maximum. Okay, pressure angle will be present over here also. Okay. In this position, if I say this is the follower motion and perpendicular, if I draw the perpendicular to it, then it will be in this direction. So you can see here the pressure angle is small and here the pressure angle is large. So likewise there will be different pressure angles on the periphery of this pitch curve. Okay. So out of them, at which point we are getting the maximum pressure angle, it is called pitch point. So these yellow color points are pitch points. Next is pitch circle. It is a circle drawn from the center of the cam to the pitch points. Okay. So circle which is passing from these two pitch points and its center is over here. So that kind of circle is called pitch circle. this red dotted circle is actually pitch circle. Next terminology is prime circle. So now prime circle is the smallest circle that can be drawn from the center of the cam and tangent to pitch curve. Okay. Now you will get confused between the definition of prime circle and base circle. Okay, they look same. It is the smallest circle that can be drawn from center of the cam. Up till this point, the definition is same. And tangent to pitch curve. Okay. Now our pitch curve is this green color dotted line, dotted curve is our pitch curve. So this circle over here is called prime circle. So now you see the difference between base circle and prime circle. Base circle is the smallest circle drawn from the center of the cam and which is tangent to cam profile. Okay. Base circle is tangent to cam profile, while as prime circle is tangent to pitch curve. Okay. So this is for roller follower and other kind of follower. But if you see the knife edge follower, okay, agar hum knife edge follower mein dekhenge, so in knife edge follower, as we have seen that this pitch curve and cam profile are similar. Okay, so at that time prime circle and base circle will be same in case of knife edge follower. Okay. So keep this thing also in mind. When you solve the problem of knife edge follower, you should have it in mind that prime circle and base circle will be same, pitch curve, cam profile will be same, and trace point will be the knife edge. Okay. Trace point will be the knife edge. Okay, so things look a little bit different for a knife edge follower. As I discussed, for a knife edge and a flat face follower, the prime circle and the base circle are identical, as I just discussed. For a roller follower, the prime circle is larger. Okay, you can see here purple color dotted circle is the prime circle. And this red color circle, continuous line circle, is base circle. So prime circle is larger than the base circle by the radius of roller. Here you can also see the difference between these two circles is actually equal to radius of the roller. Okay, here roller will be there. So it is also equal to radius of the roller. Then next terminology is lift or stroke. So in cam and follower mechanism, okay, our cam is rotating and our follower is reciprocating. So our follower is moving up and down. So lift is basically the maximum travel of the follower. मैक्सिमम डिस्टेंस कितना ट्रैवल करेगा हमारा फॉलोअर फ्रॉम द इट्स लोएस्ट पोजिशन टू द टॉप मोस्ट पोजिशन. सो दिस मोशन ऑफ फॉलोअर और मूवमेंट ऑफ फॉलोअर इज कॉल्ड लिफ्ट और स्ट्रोक. नेक्स्ट टर्मिनोलॉजी इज एंगल ऑफ ascent. Okay. It is the angle through which the cam turns when the follower rises. Okay. I have shown here the cut animation of this follower. Okay, this is not complete motion. मैंने यहाँ पे उतना ही motion दिखाया है जिस motion के अंदर हमारा जो follower है वो up movement कर रहा है. Okay. So you can see the cam is actually turning by some angle, okay, and the follower is moving up. So this angle you can see over here at the beginning of our motion, our cam is in this position. And at the end of this stroke, means when our follower is at topmost position, and at that time our cam is over here. So you can see our cam is actually rotated by this angle theta 0, or theta O, you can say theta 0, I am stating it. Okay, it is the angle through which the cam turns when the follower rises. Our follower is rising in this case. So that angle is known as angle of ascent. Next is angle of descent. So same as angle of ascent, now the motion of the follower will be in downward direction, or you can say return. Okay. It is the angle through which the cam turns when the follower returns to the initial position. So now we are considering the angle when our follower is at topmost position and now it is beginning to return. So for angle of ascent, you can see this is the starting position and this is the end position for return stroke. Okay, so now our starting our cam is in this position, vertical position, and at the end of this stroke, return stroke, our cam is at this angle. Okay, so the angle, this angle turned by cam while the follower returns to its original position is called angle of return or angle of descent. Okay. Our follower is descending, motion is in downward direction. Here also I have shown the cut animation. Okay. Only the portion where our follower is coming down. Okay. So that is called angle of descent. And the last one is angle of dwell. Okay, not last one, angle of dwell. It is the angle to which the cam turns when the follower remains in stationary at higher or lower position. So what this is saying, so you can see in this animation that our cam is rotating in this direction. Okay, I have also shown here cut section only. You observe over here, there is no motion between the follower is not moving at all. You can see it is maintaining a position. Okay. Our follower is not moving at all. You can see in this animation. Okay. While our crank is rotating by some angle. Okay. So in this position, I have showed the start of dwell. Okay. This is the starting position. At this time, the axis of cam, or you can say reference position, okay, it is in this direction, or cam is in this direction, and at the end of this stroke, our cam is in this direction. So this angle turned by the cam is called angle of dwell. Okay. You can see during this angular motion of the cam, our follower is not moving anywhere, it is maintaining its position. Okay, so that is called angle of dwell. It is the angle through which the cam turns when the follower remains stationary. It is not neither moving up nor moving down, it is maintaining its position. So that angle is called angle of dwell. And the last one is angle of action. It is the total angle moved by the cam during the time between the start of rise and the end of return of the follower. So you can see here the angle between start of rise, when our follower is starting to raise, and again coming down. Okay, so that total angle is called angle of action. You see, I have shown here starting position of rise, it is in this position, and the end position of return. You observe over here. So before starting, our cam is in this position, and let me show in this figure. So it is rotating by some angle. Okay, by chance here we are getting 180 degree, but it is not necessary that in every cam this happens at 180 degree. Okay, there may be some different angle. Okay. So this total angle is called angle of action, because all of the action are happening in this angle or angular motion. Okay. So these are the terminologies that we will use in designing a cam profile. Okay. So in upcoming lectures we will actually design this curve. Okay, we will design this curve of cam. Okay. Why this is such kind of shape, that we'll look in upcoming lectures. Okay, and how to draw this. So that's it for today's lecture. See you in the next lecture.